Hey there, this is the one Boom, and I've been gone for almost a week, and in that week, my integrity juice has risen to an all-time high, and I can only assume that this is because of my Battlefield 2042 assumptions primarily coming true. Sometimes it sucks being right. But in this video, I guess we'll use my newfound integrity to talk about something controversial, like how I don't think Call of Duty needs to drastically innovate. This video should go down pretty well. I mean, I predict it'll have zero visible dislikes. That's right. Roll film. I always wonder what people mean when they say Call of Duty needs to change. In what way? How so? How drastically? Because when I look at other franchises, I see people saying, oh god, I wish this would return to form. I wish Halo would be how I remember it. I wish Battlefield 2042 didn't deviate so much. And then I see these people saying, oh, the Call of Duty player base is so hypocritical and stupid because they want change, but then they're mad when it happens, which is the most just intellectually dishonest thing you could ever say. First of all, you can't categorize a player base of people that have varying levels of affiliation with a product, and in this case, our products are electronic toys. You can't lump them together, call them a community because they happen to play the same video game. You know, in the Call of Duty player base, if you put five Call of Duty players in a room, you'd get that one guy that only plays it for zombies, the one guy that does more competitive esports stuff, you'd get the guy that wants Call of Duty to change its gunplay, another guy that wants Call of Duty to change the movement, another guy that wants Call of Duty to change drastically, and the other guy that wishes they would return to form or just remaster old titles. And I promise you, not one of them will have showered. You see how it's really hard to call that a community? I'm not making a straw man here, that's just what would happen. You know, it's like taking a bunch of people to a restaurant. You take five people to a restaurant, they're all gonna order different things more likely than not. And when they all order those different things, are you gonna call them hypocrites for coming into your favorite restaurant and demanding something you don't like ordering? Of course not. Someone isn't dumb for not ordering your favorite food at your favorite restaurant. That's ridiculous. They have their own preferences and they're all there for different things. If you go to a Chinese restaurant and you order the cheeseburger, it's because you're in the mood for a cheeseburger, not because you woke up that day and decided sacrilege is a good idea. I hate God! It's weird seeing these people say that Halo should return to form, but Call of Duty same shit, different hat. Whereas in my opinion, the best thing for a long-running franchise to be right now is to be a high-quality version of itself. To be the same shit in a different hat, a cleaner hat. A hat more in line with the shit that it's on. In the Call of Duty franchise, we've seen the same shit, the base Call of Duty formula, with the wrong hat. And I would say Black Ops 4 is a great example of that. Black Ops Cold War is a great example of that. Because the moment-to-moment gameplay changes in those games conflict with the formula itself. Whether it's Cold War score streak system or Black Ops 4 specialist system, we can all agree those were not well-implemented ideas. We might have had fun with them from time to time, but let's really look at them in the context of the series. Do they fit? No. Same thing with Halo 4 and 5. Halo 4 and 5 are a great example because they're not terrible games in their own right. Let's be honest, they're not terrible shooters. The issue is that if you bought them for a Halo experience, you're missing out on initial positioning, and you're also missing out on fair start. So if you buy Halo 4, you have permanent sprint built into every Spartan, you have the thruster pack and a much faster jetpack, and you have loadouts. And those loadouts remove the whole, you know, on-site procurement. I'm gonna go push for the sniper rifle. You know, a sniper rifle's great, but it's a lot less tantalizing to push for the sniper in Halo 4 when you spawn in with a DMR whenever you want. If you spawned in with an assault rifle, that would be different. But no, you can spawn in with a BR or an assault rifle. You want a plasma pistol and a BR? Go for it. You can just have a noob combo class with plasma grenades on it every time you spawn in. And then Halo 5's movement was so drastically different, so fast, so fluid, and had such a learning curve to it. And there were so many moves you could do, like ground slam and shoulder charge. And the reason those things didn't work is because they removed that whole thing about Halo's initial positioning and movement commitment. Bungie didn't want you flying out into the middle of the map and flying on back. They didn't want you rounding corners at the speed of light. They wanted you to have to take things a bit slower. They wanted you to move a little bit more methodically and to worry about where your positioning is. That Halo formula is great. You can see it in CE, you can see it in 2, 3, and Reach. Elements of it in 4, although 4 really started to fuck it up, and then 5 completely ruined it. And no one can even argue with me because I own 3 of these! So, Halo 4 and 5, they're fine video games, but they're not what I want from Halo. They don't provide me with the Halo experience. In Halo Infinite, however, we all spawn in with the same weapon, and then we all scatter to our different areas of the map, trying to grab the commando, the battle rifle, the shotgun, the disruptor, the needler. We want other things on the map, so everything's tantalizing when you want everything. You don't just want to use the AR all game, even though it's pretty powerful. No, you might want a skewer, a sniper, because the pistol's good, but it's not sniper good. And while you can sprint and slide in Halo Infinite, you're slower and clunkier, meaning your movement has to have more commitment to it. When you're slower, you can't just leave a situation entirely. So, when you get into a situation, you have to be ready to fight, you have to have a buddy with you, you have to have a good combo ready, plasma pistol, BR, you have to go find those weapons out on the field. That's great, that's awesome. Like, the grappling hook is great for getting out of engagements, but you have to go find the grappling hook. You don't spawn with it all the time. That is the Halo formula. So, while everyone's praising Halo for being more of what we wanted from Halo for years now, and more of what we were trying to get out of the MCC, which, while I think the MCC is in a great place now, it is a bunch of games that we've been playing for years and years and years, over a decade, some of them. So it's nice, right? So Halo's getting this praise for this, while Battlefield is currently being lambasted for being a soulless copy of every other trendy shooter decision in the book, and Call of Duty's getting made fun of for being itself. Does Call of Duty need to drastically go the milsim route, the boomer shooter route? Should Call of Duty drastically go in a completely different direction for like 5 years? Should we have to wait 6 years to miss Call of Duty again? I mean, really, does every franchise need to have a Battlefield 2042? Does every franchise need to have a Halo 5 that makes you go, eh, this isn't a bad game, but it's not what I want from COD? Why can't my favorite shooters just die so I can miss them when they're gone? One of the things I loved about Modern Warfare 2019 is that it felt like COD 4. It felt like the modern interpretation of COD 4, Modern Warfare 2. It felt like Black Ops 1, Modern Warfare 3. It had that old formula to it. Messy, convoluted maps, the aesthetic, the tone, the time to kill. It just felt like I was playing COD again. It wasn't some weird bastardized thing like Black Ops 4 was the year before, or some boring iteration like Call of Duty World War 2. Because not only was it the old way, it had new flavor. Flavor came in the form of selector switches, gunsmith, opening and closing doors, mounting and leaning that actually is, it works and it's practical. The night vision mode, while I wish it had more support, reminded me of how Call of Duty 4 let you spawn in with NVG all the time. As if that was supposed to be some useful feature, it obviously wasn't. You had almost no practical application for night vision in COD 4. I want them to bring night vision back as a permanent addition in the next Modern Warfare that you just always have equipped. And then they could have maps that start off in the evening, but maybe the last 2 or 3 minutes of the match, it's pitch blackout, it goes into nighttime, and then you want to start using the night vision. I think that'd be fun. Those little elements of flavor added on to the Call of Duty formula make the series feel new while also playing to the strengths of why I buy into that series in the first place. Halo Infinite isn't exactly like Halo 3, but it reminds me so much of why I played Halo 3. It reminds me of why I played Halo Reach. It reminds me of what I like about that formula, and more specifically, more broadly actually, that franchise. Halo 4 and 5, while solid games for different reasons, they just don't give me what I want from Halo. And I know so many people feel the same way as me because of how many people are saying Halo is back. Not, oh, it's another Halo, it's Halo is back. So no, Call of Duty should not have to go through some crazy trial and tribulation and just get to the point where we can't recognize it or we don't want to look at it anymore. They've already done that. In my opinion, Black Ops 4 is that. Cold War has elements of that. Advanced Warfare, Infinite Warfare, Black Ops 3, they tried these different things. There's an entire period of Call of Duty that you could just call the identity crisis period. And I really do think that Modern Warfare 2019, Call of Duty Vanguard, are more in line with what I appreciate about Call of Duty. Imagine appreciating Call of Duty. Vanguard more than 2019 because it's not trying to do a big 64 player mode like Battlefield. It's not trying to do any sort of one life gunfight mode. It's not trying to do Fireteam Dirty Bomb. It's just multiplayer. It's bread and butter. Here's a bunch of weapons and a bunch of things to unlock for them and a bunch of camos and a bunch of maps and some operators. Go have fun. And I like that. Vanguard, at launch, is one of my most played Call of Duty games for a launch period. I'm streaming it for 4 or 5 hours at a time and I can't put it down because there's so much variety to tap into. I want to keep leveling up the weapons because you drastically can change the way they feel and perform. I keep enjoying my play sessions because there's so many maps and they all play differently, and that taps into what I liked as a kid. So, while Vanguard might not win any awards, and I don't think it really deserves any, I'm not gonna make fun of it for being Call of Duty. That's the wrong attitude. That's the attitude that got us Halo 5. That's the attitude that got you Battlefield 2042. Battlefield 2042 isn't playing to the Battlefield strengths. Halo Infinite is playing to the Halo strengths, and in my opinion, Call of Duty Vanguard is playing to the Call of Duty strengths. Of course, this is subjective. I'm not talking about these things as products in this video. I'm talking about design, and that's always going to be controversial, and there's always going to be so many different opinions. So many people that want massive changes and innovations. So many people that want the games to be identical, damn near identical, to what they used to be. And I don't know really where the truth lies or what a game should do. I do know one truth, however. A massive AAA game's player base is so widespread that all you're going to hear are the opinions of the different individuals who happen to have some level of affiliation with a game series. We're individual players, not a community. And to end this video with a quotable little line from me, if we're really excited for Halo to be back, let's not make the mistake of asking Call of Duty to leave. Thank you so much for coming out to this YouTube video on the website, youtube.com. Feel free to subscribe to this channel, in which I upload things like this and live stream, and I will see you in the next YouTube video here at youtube.com. See you when I see you. Goodbye.